Day 2, September
6, 2018. This 13-year-old female spit cat had no illness till now, and she was vomiting for 3 days yesterday. The owner brought her here, and she had not been eating, and she has bad breath and drank a lot of water. So the diagnosis was confirmed by blood test, evidence of creatinine. The creatinine level has, the urea level has gone up to 7 times normal, the upper range, and the creatinine level has gone up to 1,142, when normally it should be maximum 160. Now this is translated to more than 5 milligram per deciliter. Where's my the other one? This one, the one? The other copy? So this shows that the cat is suffering from stage 4 chronic kidney disease, because according to the recommended values, you can see that the stage 4, the severe kidney disease, the cat is having a creatinine level of more than 5 milligram per deciliter. But this one comes in the different unit. This is a different unit, so we convert this reading, and it's converted to 12.9. So this equivalent to 12.9 milligram per deciliter, and as you can see, 12.9 is definitely higher than 5. So this blood test evidence shows that the cat is suffering from stage 4 severe chronic disease, kidney disease. Now this is very serious. There are different stages. Stage 1, of course, there is no, it's only 1.6, so it's not serious. Stage 2 is mild chronic kidney disease. There's a value here, 1.6 to 2.8. Then stage 3 is a moderate chronic kidney disease, 2.9 to 5. So anything over 5 milligram per deciliter is considered stage 4. So this cat is definitely stage 4. And now when I did a palpation, I could feel that the kidneys were enlarged. Now I could feel 2 enlarged kidneys. The one on the left seems to be the one vertical. It feels quite vertical. And the one on the right as well, there's some pain there. Now the cat has been on the drip, so you can see that the cat is more energetic, but you can see the anemia here. It's all, now I can't show you now, but in the other video, the first video, you will see, you know, a bit pale, but it's much better now. Okay, so basically this cat has chronic kidney disease. Now we are doing the check for the three viruses. So because of the low total white cell count is low, so what is the check? FHW, antibody.
FHW, feline heartworm antibody.
Negative. The second one.
FELV is feline leukemia virus antigen.
It's negative also. One line. The one.
FIV is feline immunodeficiency virus antibody.
So it's negative. So this cat is not actually suffering from viral disease. So we already confirmed that it's a stage 4 chronic, severe chronic kidney disease. And we are giving trips now. The owner has to make a decision, because otherwise we have to treat the anemia, we have to treat dehydration, we have to give nutritional support from stomach tubing, and to ensure that phosphorus is less than 6 milligram per deciliter. So there's a lot of things to do for a severe chronic kidney disease cat. So it's up to the owner to decide. In the meantime, we are giving the drips. And the cat is being maintained on the drip. Okay, I'll finish.